साइरा निकल गया। Perhaps it has started to record. It's going very slow. Is the red recording button visible on your screen?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Yes, see, there may be some problem. Okay, so when the presentations are being made, what I will do is I'll turn my camera off and I'll put my mic on mute. Okay, so that connectivity may not hamper the recording or something like that. Okay. So before we start, I would like Priyanshi to read out the name who all are there in the list, and then in the same order you will start making your presentations. Okay, do one thing, keep your presentations within 5 minutes. Okay, so yes, Priyanshi, read out the list.
So first of all, Ramya Jain, Abhishek Yadav,
then
Shivam Masava, okay. Sachin Kumar,
Shivam, Sachin, okay.
अभिषेक भार्गव, शिवम बसावा, सचिन कुमार मीना, सौरभ शर्मा, कार्तिकी श्रीवास्तव, अतिन साहू, अंजन।
ओके, सो बेटा, हैव यू हर्ड द ऑर्डर? नाउ यू विल हैव टू मेक योर प्रेजेंटेशन इन दिस ऑर्डर ओनली, ओके? परहैप्स जतिन इज नॉट देयर, सो हूएवर इज आफ्टर जतिन विल मेक हिज प्रेजेंटेशन। सो रोम्या, नाउ इट्स योर टर्न। You can, Anushka says,
sir, I am here.
Okay, beta. Okay. Jatin is also there. Fine. So now, Romia.
Yes.
The screen is yours. You can go ahead. All the best. I am putting my camera and mic on mute. Camera close.
Okay, sir. So I am going to present the short summary of the chapter, The Necklace by Guy de Maupassant. So let's begin. This story is about a woman named Matilda Loisin who does not know how to live within her means. She belongs to a middle class family, but she always wants to live a lavish lifestyle. Her husband is a clerk who cannot afford to fulfill all her demands. One day, they both were invited for a party, but Matilda was not happy because she didn't have a beautiful dress to wear in the party. Then her husband manages to arrange a beautiful dress for her wife. But Matilda was not happy again because now she didn't have jewels to wear in the party, which suits her dress best. Then her husband suggested him to borrow jewelry from her rich friend named Madame Forestier. Then Matilda decides to borrow jewels from her friend. Then both of them went to the party. Matilda was looking amazing in the party. While returning from the party, Matilda loses the necklace. They tried to find the necklace, but they were unable to find it. Matilda and her husband spent all her fortunes and borrowings to buy a similar necklace, which cost them a fortune. After that, they have done everything which could be done to repay the loan for which they have to buy the necklace. It takes about 10 years to repay the loan. and this much of torturous period Matilda and her husband have to spend. After this torturous period, Matilda happens to meet her friend, Madame Forestier. Then she told the whole story about the loss of necklace and everything to her friend, Madame Forestier. When Madame Forestier came to know about the story of Matilda, she replied, "Oh, my poor Matilda, my necklace was just a false. It was a cheap necklace." So here comes the moral of the story. The moral of the story is, honesty is the best policy. Clearly, if Matilda had told the truth earlier only, then she didn't have to spend the torturous period which she had to spend. Thank you.
Okay, beta. Does anyone want to ask a question to Romya? Am I audible? Romya?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So, any question for Romya from the class? No questions? Okay, Romya, do you have a question to ask to the
class? Yes, sir. So, the question is, what kind of a person is Madame Matilda Loisel? Why is she always unhappy?
What kind of a person was Matilda and why was she always unhappy? Yes, who would like to answer? Anyone may speak.
Sir, can I answer?
Yes, beta.
Matilda was a lady who was always unhappy, and the reason for that was that she was always unsatisfied, and she always thought that it would be much better if she was rich. But actually, by mistake of her destiny, she was born in a poor family, and that's why she was always unhappy and she was always unsatisfied.
She had high desires. She was very demanding kind of person, and none of that could be filled in her life, and that's why she was always complaining, always unhappy. Is this what you said, beta?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Anybody else?
Sir, can I?
Yes, go ahead.
Sir, we can say that Matilda was like a greedy person. She was never was happy with what she has, but she was expecting that like main ameer ho jaun, that so that's mm-hmm. why I think she, and that's because of that only she was not happy.
She always wished for a lavish life because she felt, she thought that she is born for that, right? This was her view.
Yes, sir.
And exactly opposite of that was her life. So she considers her life as an irony, and that's why she was always unhappy, sad, complaining. Okay. Now, can anybody tell me who do you hold most responsible for the misfortune that they had to go through for 10 years? Who was actually responsible?
Matilda herself was responsible for that.
See, there are only three characters here in the story, means to be considered. One is Matilda, one is Mr. Loisel, and third is Madame Forestier, from whom they borrowed. So there are only three. Now, out of these three, who do you think is the most responsible person for their misfortune? Is it Matilda herself? Is it her husband? Because he only advised to go and get it from her friend? Or is it Madame Forestier who, when she gave it to her, did not tell that it was not a genuine original diamond necklace, she gave it and they considered it an original genuine though it was artificial. So she should have told that it was just an artificial one. So because of their honesty, they suffered. Do you understand this? Whatever was done, because Matilda was very demanding and for that reason only they had it. And when they lost, because they were honest, they wanted to repay. So they I went through all that misfortune. Well, for this, because he advised her to go and get it from her friend. Or do you hold Matilda responsible because she was very demanding? She always wanted to have something. Sneha says my voice is not audible. Is it not audible to anyone?
Sir,
so whatever I spoke in past 3-4 minutes, you couldn't hear everything.
नो सर अभी जो थोड़ी देर पहले बोला बस वो नहीं सुना
ओके फाइन हैव यू हर्ड माय क्वेश्चन हैव यू हर्ड माय क्वेश्चन
यस सर
यस सर यस सर
सो हु वुड लाइक टू आंसर हु वाज एक्चुअली रिस्पांसिबल अकॉर्डिंग टू यू और यू कैन सिंपली राइट इन द चैट बॉक्स एम फॉर मैटिल्डा एल फॉर लॉइजल एंड एफ फॉर फॉरेस्टियर यू कैन राइट इन द चैट बॉक्स देन आई विल आस्क Most have written Matilda. Not most. Everyone is writing Matilda. Okay, fine. I want one student to try and justify why Matilda. Who would speak? Who would like to speak? Yes, Anushka. Yes, Anushka.
Yes, sir. Sir, Matilda, actually, Madam Foster and Loisel, the husband and the friend, are not responsible because it's not their mistake at all. But Matilda should have at least told her friend about the lost necklace that it is lost and then she would have tried to repay it to her but she hid this thing from her that it is lost and she tried to repay it without letting her know about the lost necklace so that's her only mistake that she made if she would have told it to her earlier then she would have forgiven her and she would have not have to spend such long time in poverty and it cannot be the mistake of the husband because it was not his fault at all because he just suggested her to ask for the necklace from his her friend but this was not something which caused the necklace to be lost or their poverty 10 years and Miss Madam Forrester didn't knew about the lost necklace. That's why she didn't tell about that it was actually a false necklace. That's why it can be said that Matilda was the only person responsible for this 10 years of poverty that she spent.
Okay, fine. Does everyone think in the same way, or do you want to add something to it? Okay, fine. It's all a personal view. Whatever you think, whoever you want to hold responsible for all this situation, that's correct. Last year in class 10th, I gave an assignment on this. See, what is the end of the story? Am I audible, beta?
Yes, sir.
Fine. What is the end of the story? Matilda meets Madame Forrester and she tells her everything. And when Madame, because she was also honest, she didn't lie at all. She says that it was just 500 and it was an artificial one, not a real diamond and all. So fine, this is how the story gets into a tragic end. Okay. That they have spoiled 10 years, precious 10 years of their life. The most beautiful 10 years of their life, that youthful days of their life. But see,
सर आपकी आवाज नहीं आ रही.
यस सर आपकी आवाज नहीं आ रही है.
यस सर
What happens? Sairam?
Yes, sir.
Sairam?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Now, sir. Achha. Have you heard my question? My question is, at the end of the story, when she gave it back, means it was already given. Okay. At the end of the story, when she tells everything to Forrester, Forrester says that she did not even check when the necklace was returned, right? She did not check at all. This you know. Say yes.
Yes, sir.
Okay. She kept it in that in her cupboard. Now,
yes.
See, if because Forrester is also honest, what would she do? She would say, okay, you owed me that artificial necklace. Either you get one artificial necklace and give it to me, or you simply pay the cost of that artificial necklace. But the original diamond one, 40,000 or something, that you have given, actually is not mine. And then she returns it to them. Definitely she will return or not? She has to.
So she will
return. She has to. Now, when she returns that expensive diamond necklace, don't you think their fortune will once again change? Something that they have paid for 10 years of their life. It was such an expensive thing, such an expensive article. When they get it back, how would be their life? How would their life be?
Again. Simple.
Much better.
Much better. Much better. Definitely better than past.
Yes, yes sir.
So that 10 yes. years of struggle has resulted into getting them back something very expensive in their life. So all of a sudden, because of the diamond necklace itself, they will become little bit happier, little bit richer. If they sell it, they will get a lot of money to spend rest of their life nicely, properly. There is possibility, right? Mm. So I asked the students of 10th class last year to write a sequel story of this. What happens afterwards? Do you understand this? What happens afterwards?
Yes,
sequel. Necklace part 2. Necklace again. Hmm? Necklace returns. Something like this. Huh. Now there is another possibility. Because Forrester was not aware of this thing, that it was a real diamond one, she did not check it, she kept it in the cupboard, and probably after a year or two, somebody else came to her, like Matilda came for borrowing a necklace. Somebody else came, and Forrester has given it to that person unknowingly, considering it an artificial one. she gives it to somebody.
Again, the same story will return, I think.
And then God knows what happens. So you can proceed with this story in any way, in any direction, but you can make a sequel, a much interesting sequel. Can you?
Yes, sir.
It's not an assignment to be submitted soon. It's all for your creativity.
Yes,
whenever you find like writing, whenever you find like thinking about it, creating a good one, whenever you feel like submitting, you can. Okay, but it is an assignment for future. Whenever you feel like doing it, you can carry on and you can submit later on. Okay, I'm not giving any date for it. I hope you understood. Now, who is next? Who is next in the list for presentation?
Sir, Abhishek Bhargav.
Come on.
Sir, I have one PowerPoint presentation. Sir,
yes,
may I present? Thank you.
I'm
sir.
Turning my camera and mic off. Srishti.
Yes, sir.
No one is audible. Am I audible?
Yes, sir. Yes, you sir. Are audible.
Yes, sir.
I'm audible. Abhishek, it seems he is trying, but probably he is not getting connected or getting online.
Yes, sir.
This means, let us move on to the next participant. Priyanshi, call the next participant.
Shivam.
Yes, Shivam. You start. We'll come back to Abhishek afterwards.
Yes, sir. I am going to present the short summary of the thief story by Ruskin Bond. Anil was a 25 years old writer. He was living his life very carelessly. He was struggling to write for earning the money to run his life. One day, Anil was watching the wrestling match. He meets Anil. Hari used to old formula to flatter the person. Anil impressed and promised him that he would teach him how to write. Now both were living happily. One day, Hari saw that Anil had brought a bundle of notes. He saw him keep him under the mattress. As Hari saw the bundle of notes, his evil spirit aroused in his mind. He decided to rob Anil's that night. After taking dinner, Anil slept calmly. Hari kept to the bed and slept his hand under the mattress. He got the notes and ran away from there. He left for the railway station to board a train to Lucknow, but he missed it. He wandered through the bazaars. It was raining and Hari Singh was completely wet. There was a conflict in his mind. He not want to betray the faith of Anil. Anil was teaching him how to write and add numbers and that could transform his life. Then he left the railway station. He came to the field and sat on the bench. Just then, heavy rain was going on. He felt guilt as he had cheated an innocent person. His shirt and pajama wagged to his body because it was due to the rain. Hari Singh had a change of heart. He decided to return Anil and keep the money under the pillow. He reached the room and placed the money back. The next morning, he woke up a bit late and Anil had already made his tea. Anil offered Hari Singh 50 rupees, saying he has earned it. He told him he would have paid regularly. Now pay regularly. Hari kept his note in his hand. He realized that the note was still wet for the rain last night. Hari got that Anil had come to know about his misdeed, but there was no sadness, anger, and guilt in his mind. So the moral of the story is the human values and relations are important in life, and such values can change a person too. Thank you.
Is that all, Veda?
Yes, sir.
You're done?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Do you have any question to ask to the class?
Sai Ram.
No, sir.
Okay. Priyanshi, call the next student.
Sir, may I present Abhishek Bhargav?
Yes, you can try it.
Thank you, sir.
If it works, fine.
Yes, sir. Sir, my screen is visible.
Yes, but it is clearly visible.
Thank you, sir. Om Shri Sai Ram. I am Abhishek Bhargav. I am Abhishek Bhargav going to present my presentation on the topic, The Thief Story. Introduction to the chapter, The Thief Story. The story is written by an Ruskin Bond. In this story, a young boy makes friends with Anil. Anil trusts him completely and employ him. Does the boy betray his trust? The Thief Story. Anil was 25-year-old writer. He was living his life very carelessly. He was struggling to write for earning the money to run his life. One day, Anil was watching the wrestling match. He meets Hari. Hari used his old formula to flatter the person. Anil impressed and promised him that he would teach him how to write and add numbers and how to cook food. Now both were living happily. One day, Hari saw that Anil had brought a bundle of notes. He saw him keep them under the mattress. As Hari saw the bundle of notes, so his evil spirit aroused in his mind. He decided to rob Anil that night. After taking dinner, Anil slept. Hari crept to the bed and slipped his hand under the mattress. He got the notes and ran away from there. He left for the railway station to board a train to Lucknow. But he missed it. He wandered through the bazaar. It was raining and Hari Singh was completely wet. There was a conflict in his mind. He did not want to betray the faith of Anil. Moreover, Anil was teaching him how to write and add numbers that could transform his life. So he left the railway station. He came to the field and sat on the bench. Just then, heavy rain was going on. A chill wind was blowing. He felt guilty as he had cheated an innocent person. His shirt and pajamas stuck to his body because it was wet due to the rain. Hari Singh had a change of heart. He decided to return to Anil and keep the money under the pillow. He reached the room and placed the money back. The next morning, he woke up a bit late and Anil had already made his tea. Anil offered Hari Singh a rupees 50, saying he had earned it. He told him he would now be paid regularly. Hari kept the note in his hand. He realized that the note was still wet from the rain last night. Hari got to the know that Anil had come to know about his missed, but there was no sadness, anger, or guilt in his mind. So the moral of the story is, so we conclude that we did not cheat anyone because someone depend on us and become friend of us, we did not cheat him. Thank you, sir. Some question for everyone. Question, yes, one. Yes, sir. What made Hari Singh go back to Anil's house?
Who wants to answer? Yes, yes.
Sir, I think Hari Singh went back to Anil's house because he had a change of heart. He wanted to study and learn how to write his name and all the other sentences. And he also wanted to get a job, be paid regularly, and do not do anything which is guilty and bad for him.
Agreed, beta? Question?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Sir, there is answer also. Second question. Why it is difficult for Hari to rob Anil?
Sir, may I answer?
Sir, may I answer? Sir, can I answer? Sir, your voice is not coming.
Kartike wants to answer. Kartike, speak.
Yes, sir. It was difficult for Hari to rob Anil because Anil was helping Hari to earn money and he was also helping Hari to learn how to write his name and all. But he was educating Hari. Anil was educating Hari, and Hari thought that it would not be good for him to rob someone who was trying to help him.
Sir, can I answer?
First questioner will decide, does he agree with the answer given by Kartike?
No, sir.
He doesn't.
Sir, can I answer?
Yes, yes.
Sir, it was difficult for Hari to rob Anil because robbing greedy people is easy and robbing honest people like Anil is very difficult according to him, because the greedy people will make money after it, but the honest people will not trust anyone else but after being robbed by someone he trusts.
So may I speak?
Go ahead.
Sir, may I answer?
One by one.
Sir, it was difficult for Hari Singh to rob Anil because he was the most trusting person Hari Singh had ever met. It's easy to rob a greedy man because he can afford to be robbed, but it's difficult to rob a careless man because he doesn't even notice that he's been robbed and that talks all the pleasures out of the work.
Abhishek, agreed?
Yes, sir.
Chalo. Priyanshi, call the last presenter. We are already at 2:38. Only 2 minutes are remaining. Call the last presenter for today.
Sachin Kumar Meena.
Yes, sir.
Yes, beta.
Om Shri Sai Ram. Today, I am going to present the short summary of the lesson, The Midnight Visitor. So, it is a detective story written by Robert Arthur. So, there are three main characters in this story. The first is Possible. He is an secret agent who is going to get a secret report today. The another is Fowler. Fowler is a friend of Ossible who has came to Ossible to have an adventure. He is a writer and he has come to Ossible to have an adventure. He has had a romantic adventure. And third is Max. Max is another secret agent who is expecting the same report which Ossible is getting. So the story begins when Ossible and Fowler was going to Ossible's room. Ossible was in a hotel where he was expecting to get a report. So when Fowler meets Ossible, he was quite disappointed or amazed because he thinks that he has a different image of secret agents in his mind. He thinks that the secret agents are very smart, tall, and looks handsome. But Ossible was totally opposite. He was a fatty guy who doesn't look smart. So the writer Fowler was very quite disappointed with this, and he thinks why I have wasted the time with him. So when they both go to the room of Possible, they see that when they turn off the light of the room, Fowler gets the first thrill of the day. Fowler experiences his first thrill of the day that somebody is behind them is holding a gun. Fowler was a bit nervous. So the person who was holding the gun was Max. Max is another secret agent who was expecting the same report which Ossible was getting. So when Max says that you are going to get a report today, so the Ossible says that yes. So Max also wants the same report which Ossible was getting. So then Ossible moved to an armchair and said quietly that it's the second time in the month when somebody has entered his room without his permission from his balcony. He pointed towards the window and said, somebody has entered his balcony twice. So Max was quite amazed. Max was saying, no, I have not entered from the balcony. I have the pass key. If somebody not know what is passkey is the common key which every hotel has to for all rooms. So he had the pass key. So from pass key he entered the room. So so the Osible says that the so Osible said to Fowler that this room is attached with an another room who which they the both room are sharing a common balcony. So this is another route and for which Osible has complained to the hotel staff, but they have not taken any step. So Max was, while they were talking, there was a constant knocking at the door. So Osible, so the Max was surprised that the report will arrive at 12:30 a.m. Means after half an hour. Means it was 12 o'clock. So after half an hour, the report will arrive. But who is knocking the door? So the Osible said very confidently that there is police outside. So the Max was a bit nervous that how can the police came. So the Osible said that I am getting such an important report, so I have called the police for my protection and they came every day to check my room. So Max was a bit nervous and he moved behind to the balcony, moved behind to the close to the window and said to Osible that send the police back, either I will kill you at my own risk. So he goes near the window and jumped from the window and a screaming sound came. So the Fowler who was experiencing an adventure which he wants. So Fowler opens the room for the room and he was shocked that there was no police. There was waiter outside. So he was a bit shocked, where is the police? So Osible answered, there is no police. So Fowler says very, very nervously that then Osible replied, no, he will not come. So the because there was no balcony from where the Max jumped. So the moral of this story is you can have a very confident behavior which can make a fake illusion to the persons. Means Osible created a fake illusion for the Max that there is a balcony, but there was no balcony there. So it was after that Fowler realized that we should not judge a book by its cover. First he thinks that he is a dull man and he is a petty man, so how he can be a so good detective. But the reality is that we should not judge a book by its cover. Thank you, sir.
So with presence of mind and controlled nerves, we can handle any situation.
Yes, sir.
It may be dangerous. Is my audio there or lost?
Sir, it is there.
It's there.
Okay, fine. It's now 2:47 already. So let us stop here. I'm stopping to record.